Hello everyone, today we are going to go through the analog to digital converters. So let's start. So the objective of this video is to study analog to digital converters, shortly called as ADC, and the outcome will be the student will be able to explain analog to digital converters. So, contents of this PPT are introduction to ADC, types of ADC, and applications and selections of ADC. So, basically, in introduction, what we are going to cover is what is an analog to digital converter, why ADCs are important, and how does an ADC work. So, the scope of this video will be restricted to the introduction of A to D converters. So basically, what is an analog to digital converter? Before that, we will go through just the types of signals. So basically, there are different categories in which we can bifurcate the signals. But here, the one category that is the form of signal which are bifurcated in the two categories, or two types rather, analog and digital. So what is an analog signal? So analog signal is nothing but it is a real world signal, okay, and which is continuous with time. Example given here is temperature measured by a thermometer, right? Or also we can say speed measurement of a moving car is also a continuous signal with respect to time, and which is a real world signal. It is called as an analog signal. Again, in this diagram, it is shown here the analog signal, which is in the continuous form in time and value. So, time is on x-axis, some function of time is on y-axis. Suppose it may be a velocity or speed, we can say. So, according to time, the speed is continuously changing. The value of speed is continuously changing. Sorry. So, it is called as an analog signal. Then the next one is digital signal. So digital signal, obviously it is in discrete in time and value. It can be a binary digit number containing value 0 or 1. The example given is light switch. Okay, we use light switch in our houses. It has only two positions, either it is switched on or switched off. So on means it will give 1 as an binary bit digit, and off means 0 as a binary digit. So you can again see this graph here. The value is either 0 or 1 for a signal. So it is continuously changing between 0 and 1. A square wave is shown here with respect to time. So time is again on x-axis and the function is on y-axis, which has two values only, either on or off, and continuously signally changing between on and off. So if suppose we switched on and off the light for particular time interval, say suppose after each 1 minute, so we can say here this time is 1 minute. So suppose this is switched off after 2 minutes, again for 1 minute it is in switched off condition, then again at this moment again the light is switched on for 2 minutes. So again here from this 2 minutes, for 2 minutes it was on, again light was switched off, again it value becomes 0. For 3 minutes it is 0, again it is on. For 1 minute again off. So likewise it will give us only 0 and 1 as an input if we use sensor there. It is not the case, it will be continuously changing with time, and at every moment, or you can say whatever the scale here is, maybe a microsecond or a second or a minute, whatever you can keep here, for each point on the x-axis the value will be varying continuously. Okay. So this is a continuous signal, which is analog signal. This is a discrete signal, or it is called as a digital signal. So these are two types of signals. Now what is an ADC? So ADC is nothing but it is an analog to digital converter. Okay, so it is an electronic device that converts a continuous analog input signal into a discrete digital numbers or binary numbers. or a digital signal, you can say. Okay, so this is about the analog signal, digital signal, and an analog to digital converter. So why ADC is important now? So why analog to digital conversion is important? What is the need of doing conversion? So basically, all microcontrollers or other digital devices which we are going to use in the circuit store information using digital logic. That is, it will work on only digital input. The continuous input will be invalid for such components in the circuit. So we need to convert the analog signal into digital signal. Okay. So again, those devices compress information into digital form for efficient storage. Medium for storing digital data is more robust, and digital data transfer is more efficient. Digital data is easily reproducible. These are few reasons for again conversion of analog signal into digital form. Okay, so it again provides a link between real world signals and data storage. Again, as I said you, data storage will be easy in digital form rather than in continuous form. So these are the few reasons why we need to go for analog to digital conversion. Okay. So now, how an analog to digital converter works. Okay. So basically, there are three steps for working of an ADC. Here you can see an analog input is given to A to D converter and it produces some binary output. Here it is a 3-digit output. D0, D1, D2 are the 3 bits in which the output is available. So, 3 stages are: first is sampling, second is quantization, and third is coding. So, by using these 3 steps, we are going to convert a continuous analog signal in a discrete digital binary form. So, what is done in sampling? So, in sampling, the reduction of continuous signal to a discrete signal is done, and which is achieved through a sampling and holding circuit. So, sample and hold circuit is separate electronic circuit available in the system. By switching it on, we are going to form the sampling of signal. It will charge the capacitor, and again by switching it off, the voltage is stored in the capacitor, which is called as a hold operation. And the value must, the sampled value must be held for digital conversion. So sampling is done in a way, here again we can see the in diagram, we are having an analog signal here. So the first step will be, what we are going to do is, we are going to sample the signal. So here it is, sampling pulses are available. So what we are going to do is, we are going to sample the signal, which is an analog signal, and for this, what we are going to use is, we are going to use Nyquist criterion. So how many samples are to be actually taken from an analog signal, that will be that must be decided. So sampling rate depends upon the clock frequency of the A to D converter. Again here, Nyquist theorem, what does the Nyquist theorem say? That is, the sampling rate must be greater than or equal to 2 times the maximum frequency available in a continuous signal. So whatever may be the maximum frequency which is available in an analog signal, the double of that will be the number of samples which are to be taken for the conversion of that analog signal to digital form. So how that is done? So you can see in this figure, the A figure is an analog signal. The B figure is just sampling pulses. That is how we are going to take the samples. Then the C figure will give us a sampled signal. So sampling is done in the signal, and then D is sampled and hold signal. That is every time the sampled value is held at one level. That is seen in the 4 diagram. Okay, so this was regarding how sampling is done. So sampling will be done of a signal on the basis of Nyquist theorem, and number of samples will be created, and the values of values will be held at that particular position. The next step is quantizing or quantization. So what we are going to do here, you can see again in the figure. So again on x-axis there is time and on y-axis there is some function of time. So you can see here in a gray color is one continuous signal is available, and these dotted lines are nothing but these are all samples, or this is sampling rate. So particular samples are done, and at every point where this sampling line cuts the signal, the one horizontal line is marked at each point. So this is nothing but it is quantizing. At every intersection we are going to draw horizontal lines, which will be giving us the levels of quantizations. So it approximates a continuous range of values and replaces it with a binary number. So see here, at this point there is some time function, and this values of the function for particular this time period are approximated with one binary digit here. Okay, so this is approximated by this value. Again, this signal or this quantity is approximated by this value. So quantization is nothing but it is approximation of the signal, analog signal, in a digital form. Okay, now error introduced between input voltage and output binary representation. Obviously we can see here the actual value will be this, but the digital value will be this. So this much amount of error is present in the conversion. So error depends on the resolution of an ADC. So every ADC will be having its own resolution, and if the resolution is very high, the error produced will be very less, and if the resolution is less, error produced will be more. So again, this is quantizing. What we have done is we have taken each sample with intersecting points, and one binary value will be present there. So it is quantization. The next step is coding. Now the each quantization level will be, so that was the quantization levels. We decided the levels first. In coding, what is there? The each quantization level will be having its own binary code, and quantized discrete signals is converted to a series of binary bits called as a word. So at each point we will get, so this is at the intersection point there is one number. So we are going to draw the line likewise, like this here, then here, here, like this. So each level will be having its binary code, which is called as a word. Again, this word length will be characterized by again resolution. So if resolution is high, the number of bits will be more and the word length will be more. If the resolution is less, the number of bits will be less and the word length will be less. So here it is a 3-bit number. So actually 3-bit number represents an octal system. From 0 to 8 are the different levels, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. So there are total 8 quantization levels present in this particular given figure. So this is an analog signal, irregular analog signal is there. Sampling rate is also present, and at every point what we are going to do is we are going to have a number representing the line. Okay, so this is coding. So accordingly, at each point coding will be done, and that coding will give us the digital binary output at that point of time. So this is the process of A to D conversion. Now few glimpses on the resolution, as we have already gone through the point of resolution. So in resolution, what we are going to do is we have to minimize the error between the conversion of analog signal to a digital signal. So we need to keep the error minimum, so we need to keep the resolution maximum. So error is reduced with more available memory. So again, we need to have more memory. If the bits are more, we need more memory to store the bits. So here again, we can see here there are few mathematical formulations are present. V range is nothing but input voltage range, and N is the number of bits of an ADC. So resolution will be V range divided by 2 power n minus 1. This is the formula here. So suppose here example is taken, range is taken as 7 volt and the bits are taken as 3. So here we can see here 3 bit ADC is taken. So here there are total possibilities of 3 bit digits is 2 power again 3, that is 2 power n will be the possibilities of different combinations, as binary are having 2 digits only, one is 0 and the other one is 1. So binary code will be available in zeros and ones only. So the possibility is 2, that is 2, and again we are going to take 3 bits, so it is 2 power n, n is 3, so 2 power 3 is 8. So total 8 combinations will be possible of zeros and ones. So this will be again shown in this level. There are 8 quantization levels are present, 000 to 111. These are 8 possibilities. Again, we can convert these to decimal numbers, like this is 0, this is 1, this is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So 0 to 7 are the value of voltages available here. And again, the analog voltage is also shown here on the x-axis. So it is in 0.5 range, so it is increasing by 0.5. so this x-axis shows us from 0 to 7.5 volts, and y-axis gives us quantization level from 0 to 7. So again, so V range is 7 volts. If you provide 7 volts and the bits are 3 for ADC, then what we get here is resolution will be equal to V range, that is 7 divided by 2 power n minus 1, that is 2 power 3 minus 1. So 7 divided by 2 power 3 is 8 minus 1, 7. 7 divided by 7, that is 1 volt. So our resolution here is 1 volt. If we go for more number of bits in ADC, if it is 4, that is the value of n becomes 4, then what happens? 7 divided by 2 power 4 minus 1, that is 2 power 4 is 16. 16 minus 1, that is 15. So 7 divided by 15. So it will be less than 1 then. Okay. So actually here again, one more formula, that is for error, quantization error is again plus minus resolution divided by 2. So here as resolution is 1 volt, the error which is available in the conversion is 0.5 volts. So again we can see here, at this point, see here, this is the original continuous signal. Okay. So it is, we can see this is the original signal, which is a continuous inclined line, we can say. And at this point where the 1 volt is supplied, okay, at this point what we can get, so from 0.5, so here at 0.5 this signal is here, okay, but at 0.5 input voltage what we are getting here is again the value 1 as an digital output. Again at 1.5 also we are going to get 1. So at 0.5 signal we are getting 1, that is plus 0.5 volt is error, and at 1.5 again we are getting 1, that is minus. So this is the actually error present here. So from 0.5 volt to 1.5 volt of an analog output voltage, the digital output voltage will show us 1 volt only. So from 0.5 to 1.5 we'll get only 1 as an output, so which is having error. At 0.5 it will show 1, that is it has plus 0.5 error, and at 1.5 it will show again 1, that is minus 0.5 error will be there. Okay, so that will be error available. So that is, again, if we increase the number of bits in ADC, again, as I said, it is, if we are going to use 4 bits, so total possibilities will become 16. So we can get 16 quantization levels here in this diagram. Instead of these are 8, the quantization levels will again become minimum. So again, resolution divided by 2. So again, here the value will be 7 divided by 15. And that will be the resolution, and again error will become 7 divided by 2 into 50, that is 7 divided by 30 will be the value of error, which will be again very, very, very less. So as we are going to use increase the number of bits, the value of the error resolution will be more and the error will get minimized. So this was regarding the resolution of an ADC, how the error can be minimized, that we are going to see here. So again here the same figure is shown. Here is an analog input which is given to the ADC, and again 3 bit output we can see here, as here it is shown on the diagram. So the maximum change in the input required to produce a 1 bit change in the output is 1 volt. So we need to provide 1 volt to get the change in the output. So here we cannot go in between values. So again this signal is continuously changing from 0 to 0.5, it is changing from 0.5 to 1 also, it is changing. But to change in getting change in output, we need to give 1 volt input, right? So this we can say in this diagram of resolution. The next here again whatever I told you in that last diagram, here it is represented in again tabulated as well as graphical form. So here it is original analog signal. With high resolution we can get the shape nearly equal to this, like this. You can see here nearly equal shape can be produced with very high resolution. At low resolution you will get a different shape. See here the at the top and at the bottom side we can get the flat lines. So flat horizontal lines, which is not the case here. Here it is at the top side and bottom side, and analog signal has only one point. So as we are going to increase the number of resolutions, the flat line will be getting shortened, and at one point we can get a very short flat line here if we increase the number of bits. Here again show resolution, that is number of bits are increased. It was 4 bits to 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16 bit. Discrete states, as I said you, it will be 2 power n. So 2 power 4, 16, 2 power 6, 64. Likewise, for 16 bit, we can go for 65,536 different quantization levels. Accordingly, see here values of the Qs for 10 volts supplied voltage. So at 16 bit, what can you measure? The smallest value is minimum voltage step recognized by an ADC. So this can be recognized by an ADC. It is 153 microvolts, which is possible with 16 bits. And compared to the 4 bit, it is 0.625 volts. So that is the major difference. See, if binary bit you are going to consider, see here the numbers. It is 0.0625 and it is here 0.00153. So this is the difference. So that can be achievable with the high resolution. So basically in all, what I wanted to see here is, if the analog signal is to be converted to a digital signal, which is the requirement of a circuit, as the digital circuit or microcontrollers, microprocessors or PLCs or computers won't work on analog signal, they need digital signal for the working, or a binary signal for a working. So we need, and in real world whatever the signals we are going to get, all will be continuous with time. So all signals will be an analog signal. So we need to convert those analog signals in digital form so that those can be understood by the system and can be the program can be run and can operations can be performed according to the requirement of the system. So that is regarding the A2D conversion process or introduction to A2D converters. In next video we'll be going through the different types of A2D converters which we are going to go through. Thank you.